Do you opt for happiness as an assistant medical examiner? Like you never wanted more.
Of course I wanted more. As much as it scared me, but be careful what you wish for and all that.
Dr. Mallard, how awesome you're here. Again.
Doc. Relax, Jethro. I'm not here as ME, purely in my consultant capacity.
Well, I was just about to tell Agent Gibbs about some nasty old chemical burns I found on Sergeant Hill, our most recent victim. I actually was able to work backward from the contracture of the scarring to establish a likely pH and molarity level of the chemicals involved.
Clever.
Sergeant Hill likely got these scars in a makeshift lab while trying to create this poison, making him our prime suspect.
That's very clever.
Dr. Mallard's praise that day convinced me to finally finish med school and take the ME test.
Really, what happened?
What do you care, Ryan?
Yeah, fine, you got me. My dying wish is to know whether you passed the test.
No, I didn't. Not the first time, or the second time. So I never told anyone at work.
I need to talk to Gibbs. Is he still in MTAC?
They still don't know.
Know what?
About the third time, when I passed.
You passed the ME's test.
Yeah, I aced it. It was so strange. I had spent so long just trying to prove myself, trying to get ahead. When I finally passed the test, it hit me like a ton of bricks. I didn't want to go anywhere else. I didn't want to leave my friends, especially not Dr. Mallard. I was happy where it was.
So you're an actual doctor.
I am. But still nobody at work knows. You got a special dynamic. I don't want to mess that up.
But you could go anywhere.
And I will one day. Nothing lasts forever. I have had so many friends come and go. And live. And die. But where I'm at right now with Dr. Mallard and Abby and the rest of our team working for what I really think is a noble cause. Why would I want to leave that? I'd rather be happy. So every day I put on my scrubs or this old jumpsuit. I go to work and I opt for happiness.
Abby?